We have three stories tonight about three very different people. The first story, about as St. Louis as you can get. It's Patrick Murphy's profile of a Southsider who very early in his life just took to a style of music and just stuck with it.
When Billy Peek sings, "Can a White Boy Play the Blues?" he pays homage to his African-American mentors while posing the question, could a kid from South St. Louis really grow up to share the stage with the world's blues greats? The answer is yes.
On Tower Grove. That was my home for the first 14 years of my life. Then we moved up between Shoto and Gibson, and my dad, you know, decided to open up this bar, and so we moved, and we moved up over the bar. And the great that was that it gave me, started me out with a proving ground to play my music, because my dad played the music there, and my mother, she tended the bar there. And we played music in there. I played music with my dad, and we were playing country music, and I was kind of, you know, getting used to playing in front of people and doing my thing. And then about 1955, I was in an ice cream parlor, and I went up to the jukebox, and this friend of mine comes over to me. He says, "Man, play this number here." He says, "You ain't got a song." So back then it was like a nickel, you know. I drop a nickel in, I hit this number. Maybelline, can't you be true, you know? It changed my life. Because from that point on, I thought, man, I didn't know you could play the guitar like that.
Drop my coin right into the slot. You gotta hear something that's really hot. With the one you love, you're making romance. All day long, you've been wanting to dance. Feeling good from hell.
St. Louis was a leader in this new sound called rock and roll. St. Louis rock was raw and edgy. It had energy. And Billy was at the center of it, learning licks from Ike Turner and Chuck Berry.
I always think of Chuck Berry like country music meets rhythm and blues. Like, so for instance, here's some of his classic licks. This is like the intro to Johnny B. Goode. I think what I play is truly St. Louis music, because I think Ike Turner and Chuck Berry created a sound in this town. And there were others. There was Albert King and there was Lil Milton, but Ike and Chuck were my guys. I went to Roosevelt High School, and in 1956, Ike Turner and the Kings of Rhythm played a prom. I went to the prom, and there I see a Ike Turner playing this guitar, and I'm going, man, now here's another thing you can do with the guitar, you know? And you could always tell when Ike Turner was playing the guitar, because, you know, that whammy bar, man. So then I started like zeroing in, I mean, heavy duty on Ike Turner and Chuck Berry. Those were my two guys.
In 1958, Billy Peek cut his first record, a tune called Pretty Blue-Eyed Baby. The kids loved it, and he was picked up by a band called the Satellites, which played Saturday nights at the Broadview Hotel in East St. Louis.
What made it interesting was that any artist came in and was on the St. Louis Hop to promote their record would be brought to the Broadview, because we had 1,500 kids, which in 58 was unheard of, you know. And so they would come over, and I met people like Buddy Holly there, and Eddie Cochran, the Everly Brothers. All these guys had these hit records coming through. And believe it or not, they would have these little record players like at the Broadview, and they would put their record on there, put a mic down by it, and they would mount their record to their little, you know. I mean, that's the way they did it. So, because everything was pantomimed, even on the St. Louis Hop, you just pantomimed your record, you know.
It was also in 1958 that Billy first opened for Chuck Berry at the Casa Loma Ballroom. It was the beginning of a lifelong musical relationship. In the early 60s, Billy played in clubs all over town, including Gaslight Square. In the mid-60s, he moved to Los Angeles and played at the Hollywood A-Go-Go.
But I got so homesick. Because I mean, I'm if you think of anybody being a St. Louisan, Billy Peek's definitely a St. Louisan. And I got homesick and I came back home.
It turned out to be a good move. With St. Louis as his home base and Chuck Berry his mentor, Billy Peek and his signature Flying V Gibson guitar began appearing everywhere. National audiences watched him on the television show Midnight Special. He toured with Chuck Berry in the early 70s. When Rod Stewart Faces broke up, he chose Billy to be in his new group.
That band stayed together for 6 years, and it ended up being 4 albums, 3 world tours. It was probably one of the greatest rides of my life. I guess I'm from the old school. I will give an audience as much as they'll give me. If I get up there and that audience starts to rev me up, then I'm gonna rev them up. It's like I play off of them, they play off of me, you know. Really, it's a feeling, you know. I've seen people that can play the blues, and I've seen people that play at the blues. And the difference is that they have soul. And the person playing at it, he just doesn't have the soul. The feeling isn't there. If you play one note and play it with soul, it's better than playing 100 notes through a 12-bar frame. It's like it's bending, you know? It's like. I'm in the studio and recording a tribute album to my mentor, Chuck Berry. And every song on the is one of his compositions, you know. I just felt that I needed to do this, if for no one else, just for Chuck. I mean, I hope everyone likes it, but mainly I hope Chuck likes it.
Hey you, rock and roll.
You find out as you get older that you may be good at your craft, but there's always somebody better than you. And so, you know, you don't need to walk around with your head up in the clouds, because just be thankful that you've been blessed, that you can play.
Get a white boy! Get a white boy! Thank you.